you guys, so in today's video, I am going to be giving you some tips and tricks for managing anxiety. As someone who has struggled with anxiety for basically her entire life, I have come to a point where I feel comfortable enough and I feel secure enough in myself to be able to give advice to others about the ways that I manage my anxiety on a daily basis. I have gotten to the point where my anxiety has gotten pretty minimal because I work so hard at managing it, and I just sort of wanted to share that with you guys, and hopefully I can help somebody out. So yeah, if that interests you, keep on watching. Also, for those of you guys who don't know me, my name is Neva, I am 25 years old, and I currently live in Germany with my husband Ben, and I just like to make all different kinds of videos. Some of them are about living in Germany as an American, but some of them are just random topics that I just want to speak about. So if you're curious about any of that, you can check out my other videos. And with that all said, let's get into tips and tricks for managing anxiety. So the first thing that I want to talk about, the first thing I think is like the most important, is mindfulness. Now, what I mean when I say this is simply being in touch with your emotions and your feelings. And I know that when I say that, you're probably thinking, well, yeah, I mean, I always know what I'm thinking and feeling. But what I mean is like a little bit more specific than that. And I think a perfect example for understanding this is if we look at when we're in an argument with somebody and we start getting angry and upset with this person and we start saying things without really taking the time to fully think through what we're saying. And I think the reason for this is because we have this underlying feeling like we're either hurt by what this person did or said, or you know, something about what they have done has made us upset. And without taking a minute to step back and think about that, oftentimes what will happen is negativity will just start coming out of us because we're feeling hurt. And we often say things that we don't really mean because it's just spur of the moment. Now, if we take a minute when we're in an argument and we just step back and we reflect about what we're really feeling and we kind of pinpoint exactly what's wrong and what we're upset about, oftentimes it's much easier for us to go to the other person and say, hey, this is what I'm really upset about, and then have a genuine discussion about it. Without self-reflection, it's incredibly difficult to really recognize what exactly is bothering us and then to figure out how we can fix it. When we don't self-reflect, oftentimes we don't really think about what's wrong and we're just simply reacting on instinct without the understanding of how we really feel about a situation. I know that there are so many times when I get up in the morning and I have anxiety and I just sort of feel bad and I can't really pinpoint why. And what I like to do in that situation, when I wake up in the morning and I'm feeling bad, I'll sit down and I'll start to write about what I feel bad about. And oftentimes I'll find by the end of writing out my thoughts that there were a lot of things bothering me that I didn't even really notice that those were the things that were making me feel bad or making me have anxiety. I just sort of felt like I had this generalized anxiety until I really took the time to write out my feelings and thoughts and I could pinpoint exactly what was upsetting me. So yes, mindfulness is super important. Just taking the time for yourself to figure out what's going on in your own head. And I think you'll find oftentimes that you didn't even realize what exactly was causing your anxiety, but once you know, it's much easier to handle. Okay, so the next tip I have for managing anxiety is to focus on your physical health. Now, I think that we all kind of roll our eyes when somebody says this when we're talking about mental health because we don't want to think about the fact that our physical health is really connected to our mental health. I know that I used to never care about what I ate. I didn't care about nutrition. I didn't care about exercising. I wasn't caring about my physical body, but then I was still upset that my mental state was not where I wanted it to be. The truth of the matter is, when your body is physically healthy, you will feel mentally better. I promise. It really, really helps to just get exercise and to feed your body the food that it needs to fuel it to feel good. I know on the days that I exercise, I will feel much better, much more productive. Now, part of it is definitely that when you exercise and eat well, you will feel physically better. But the other part of it is you can feel like you've accomplished a task. After your workout, you will feel accomplished for having exercised. When you make yourself a healthy meal, you will feel accomplished for having spent that time in the kitchen to feed your body something that is good for it. So it's sort of half and half. Part of it is genuinely that good food and exercise will help your body feel better, and the other part of it is you will feel like you are doing something good for yourself. And I think both of those things are incredibly important when you have anxiety. So the next point I'm going to be making is to feed your soul. Now, this sounds a little bit funny when I say it like that, but essentially what I'm saying is do what makes you feel good, do what makes you happy. And for me, that means playing my guitar, making music, or writing in my journal, or drawing, or sometimes even exercising, but not always. Whatever it is that makes you feel happy, makes you feel successful, and just gives you joy, generally speaking, you should be doing that as much as you possibly can. Recently, I have been really getting into yoga, and I know that after I spend just 15 or 20 minutes doing yoga, I'll just feel better because I enjoyed the time I spent doing it. If you get a lot of joy from sitting down and watching a horror movie, then you should make sure that maybe once a week or twice a week or whatever, you just sit down and watch a horror movie. Put that time aside just for you, just to do something that you love. Because once you start feeding your soul in this way, your mental health will appreciate it. Now, of course, just doing things that make us happy, that's not gonna end your anxiety, but it will definitely help it. I know that on a day where I do a bunch of things that make me happy and make me smile, I will have less anxiety. So find what makes you happy and try to really make sure you put time aside for yourself so you get to do this as much as you can. So the last point that I have is something that maybe doesn't apply to everyone, but I think a lot of people that struggle with anxiety struggle with feeling like they're in control. And I know I have a really difficult time with this. If I feel like things are out of my control, it gives me anxiety. So I like to do things that make me feel like I am in control of my life, of my day, of my time, all of that kind of stuff. For me, that means doing a lot of scheduling. Like, I like to schedule everything that's going on, write everything down in my notebook. It also means making lists. Now, what I love to do is every single morning when I get up, I will write out a list of everything that I need to get done that day, all the chores or appointments or work or whatever it is, I'll write all of it down. Just having this list in front of me so I can see everything that I need to do that day really makes me feel better. I feel like I'm in control of everything that's going to happen during the day, and it gives me a really just relaxed feeling. Also tied into this is I like to really focus on handling one task at a time. So what I love to do is I have this piece of paper that has all of my chores and the stuff I need to get done that day on it. I will take another blank piece of paper and put it on top so that you can only see the first chore on the list. Basically, after I finish that chore, I'll cross it out and I'll move the paper down so I can see the next chore on the list. By doing this, I'm basically tricking my brain into viewing that there's only one task on my list. Now, this is kind of weird, but I really think this helps. It means that I have to only focus on that one task and I don't have to worry about all the other things that I'm going to have to do later because that's not important in the moment. In the moment, only that one first task is important. I also just want to add on as like a quick little last point is I know that this doesn't apply to everyone, but I know that when the space around me feels clean and organized, I will feel better and I will have less anxiety. So every single morning when I get up, the first thing I do is pick up the area around the house. So that means getting rid of all the stuff on the floor and cleaning the kitchen and getting everything looking fresh and organized. Then I will handle the rest of my day because once my like workspace essentially is clean and organized, I feel more capable of taking on the rest of the day and the other tasks that I have to get done. So I think that's all of the tips and tricks I have for you guys today. I feel like I could make a massive list of all the little things I like to do, but I wanted to just focus on these like main points basically. So if you have anxiety, just know that you are not alone. There are so many of us struggling like every single day. Sometimes just days are hard, and yeah, I just really hope that these tips can be somewhat helpful to you. And if you like this video, please hit that like button. And if you would like to support me and my channel, hit that subscribe button. But if you don't want to, I will not hold it against you. All right, you guys, I hope that you're having an amazing day wherever you are, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!